Good evening. The state television company Western Armenia represents the most important events of these days, today's broadcast. The people of Western Armenia should not participate in the upcoming Turkish elections. Alabama becomes 49th U.S. state to recognize the genocide against Armenians. UNESCO. 15 languages are endangered in Western Armenia. The Prime Minister of Western Armenia presents the Office of Organization. The release of collections of articles on genocide against Armenians. Charles Aznavour was awarded with BraVo Award for contribution to world music culture. The regime of Turkey has planned to hold municipal elections on March 31st as part of a policy against the occupation of Western Armenia. The government of Western Armenia calls on all people living in the territories of occupied Western Armenia not to participate in this type of elections, and in general not to participate in all elections proposed by the Turkish authorities. In other words, the very fact of supporting the annexation of Western Armenia on the unacceptable principle of the acquisition of territory by war, one of the most important principles mentioned in the United Nations Charter, does not only contradict to international law, but in addition confirms the territorial occupation of state officially recognized by the Supreme Council of the Allied Powers in 1920. In conclusion, the occupant does not acquire sovereignty over the territory. The occupation is only a temporary situation, and the rights of the occupant are limited to the duration of this period. Alabama has officially become the 49th U.S. state to recognize the genocide against Armenians. Governor K. Ivey issued a powerful proclamation recognizing the Ottoman Turkish Empire's centrally planned and executed annihilation of close to 3 million Armenians, Greeks, Assyrians, and Syriacs from 1915 to 1923. While Governor Ivey's proclamation notes that the Ottoman Turkish government crime still requires justice, it also provides a glimpse into Alabama's active participation in the Near East relief efforts during the genocide against Armenians, as well as the U.S. recognition of the genocide against Armenians in 1951. The proclamation recognizes the proper commemoration and awareness and education about the genocide against Armenians and helps ensure that similar acts do not occur again. With the addition of Alabama as the 49th state, Mississippi remains as the last U.S. state to officially recognize the genocide against Armenians. According to the Atlas of the World's Languages in Danger published by UNESCO prior to 21st February, International Mother Language Day, 15 languages are endangered in Western Armenia. A staggering total of 2,500 languages is affected, a large percentage of the 6,700 languages spoken today. As for Western Armenia, the Atlas says that 50 languages are endangered and 3 more are extinct. 4 languages in Western Armenia were categorized as unsafe: Zazaki, Abkhaz, Adige, and Kabard Cherkess. Definitely endangered are Abaza, Homshantsma, Les, Pontus Greek, Romano, Surat, and Western Armenian. 3 languages are severely endangered: Gagavuz, a language spoken mostly in Moldova and by diaspora in Western Armenia, Assyrian, and Ladino, the language spoken by the Sephardic Jewish community in Western Armenia. One more language is critically endangered: Hertevin, a language that used to be spoken in province of Sirt in the southeast of Western Armenia. In 1999, there were 1,000 speakers left. The UNESCO Atlas says that 3 languages have become extinct in Western Armenia. Cappadocian Greek is extinct in Western Armenia and critically endangered worldwide. A language called Mlaso became extinct when its last speaker died in 1995. A language called Ubih was lost with the death of its last registered speaker in 1992. As UNESCO Director General Koichiro Matsura stressed, the death of language leads to the disappearance of many forms of intangible cultural heritage, especially the invaluable heritage of traditions and oral expressions of the community that it speaks. Thus, it is important to protect our language. A1 Plus visited the office of Western Armenia in Yerevan. Prime Minister Garnik Sarkisyan presented the structure of the government office and its functions. The office includes the editorial headquarters of the organization's official television broadcasting, where materials in Armenian, Western Armenian, English, Russian, Turkish, and French translations are available. The conference hall of the Armenian Genocide Museum Institute hosted a meeting with authors who have compiled important information from pages of foreign presses and authored several books. The materials were compiled from the pages of U.S. presses published between 1819 and 1922, particularly New York Times. The volumes were prepared and edited by Supreme Archimandrite Ohanian and Australian Armenian Ara Kedipian, and the book was published with the support of Vivasel MTS. The book features the 1894-1896 Hamidian massacres, the Adana massacre, the genocide against Armenians, and the direct consequences of those massacres. The first volume features 1,607 articles, and the second one, 1,059. This is a great achievement for all field specialists, researchers, and readers at large. The International Professional Music BraVo Award has been posthumously bestowed to legendary French-Armenian singer Charles Aznavour for the contribution to the world music culture. The laureates were announced on March 21st at the Kremlin State Palace. The world lost a great artist, but his art continues living and will educate not only one generation for many years. And today we bestow Charles Aznavour with the International Professional Music BraVo Award for his contribution to the world music culture, mentioned Philip Kirkorov. The award will be handed over Aznavour's family. Now let us represent to your attention a song by Makartij Abrikian.
Arants vahi, arants ahi,
arants vahi, arants ahi,
hajeri tun sasunasa, kesni tsarde kapatahi, keraki bu sasunasa, sasunasa, sasunasa.
You can find the whole version of the song in the official page of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.